Hi all. In this video, let's understand the differences between a framework and a library. Both the framework and the library are the code written by someone, which we'll be using to solve the common problems. So let's take in this way. Framework is like buying a new house where you no need to deal with all the construction and building problems. But the only thing is you can't sort the rooms. You can't sort the rooms. It means if you choose any of the framework, you need to go with that framework. Whatever the framework provides, you need to go with that framework. That's it. But you no need to think about all other related problems. So it gives us a clear platform to run. Whereas coming to library, so if in a home, you need to have an office table. So you no need to build it from scratch. You can go to any of the IKEA store and you can get your office chair ready. So in similar way, you can get the libraries from NPM based upon your usage. So this is about library, this is about framework. Okay. So coming to how we need to code the library or framework. So here we need to tell. So our code needs to tell to the library what to do exactly. So this is my requirement, do this work. So we need to call the library. Our code needs to tell what the library needs to do. So this is about a library. Whereas framework will tell what to do. So it means it will provide some places where we can plug our code. It will call our code accordingly. So here framework has a control and it will tell what to do exactly with our code. And this framework means it can consist of n number of libraries as well. So coming to the inversion of control. So what does exactly it mean? When we are using a library, so if you are using a library, we are in charge of the application flow. It means we need to control the library, when and where to call this library. So when we are using a framework is responsible. And it will provide us some places, as I discussed. So we need to place our code there. We need to plug our code there. And framework will take care of the application flow. So coming to the library. So library focuses only on how to use it. It will not support the global state management, routing, forms, HTTPs, etc. It will only focus how to use that. That's it. So it will give us a choice of the user ability. So user can pick whatever the library he want. So for example, React.js is a library. It picks the Redux to maintain the global state. It picks the Axios to do the HTTP calls. So in this way, a library will not support any of these things. It's our ability to pick any of the library for our use case. With the libraries, we'll be having full control on the application. Only we can add whatever is necessary and whatever we want. In that way, the application goes in a smooth way. Coming to the framework, framework will tell us what to do. It means it will provide the best practices and best tools to support us, and also the style guides to follow. And overall, it will give us a ready to ship everything for a large scale application. If once we are familiar and once we explore all the topics in a framework, we'll be capable of building a large scale application. Coming to the framework. So this is about the differences between a library and the framework. So let's see that with the Angular and the React. So if you see in an Angular.js, so Angular.js is a framework which will support the routing, forms, and HTTPS by default. This framework itself provides all these details. Whereas coming to the React, React.js is a library. It is not a framework. So it will provide only the minimal usage of the library. So whereas if you want to use the state management for the global state management, you need to go with the Redux. For the HTTP calls, you need to go with the Axios. For the forms, you need to go with the Redux forms or some other forms. But it will not provide by default. So this is all about library and framework differences. So hope you understand the video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos.